When Los Angeles Dodgers Spanish-language broadcaster Jaime Jarrín announced this week that he would retire in 2022 after a 64-year career, the first thing José de Jesus Ortiz did was look through his phone. The 49-year-old is the founder and editor-in-chief of Esquina, a website that tells stories about Latinos and sports. Ortiz, a longtime baseball writer, said his publication wouldn't exist without Don Jaime. It's not hyperbole. Jarrín, you see, has been there at every part of Ortiz's career. He was the voice narrating the Dodgers' magical 1981 Fernando Mania year, when Ortiz's family was the only Mexican household on their block in Linwood. Jarrín was there with a welcome, ¿Cómo estás? ¿Cómo te llamas? How are you? What's your name? When Ortiz stepped into Dodger Stadium's press box for the first time in 1994 as an intern with the Long Beach Press-Telegram. As Ortiz's career took off, and he bounced around from Florida to New York, Houston to St. Louis, Jarrín always made time to meet Ortiz for lunch, or catch up with a pregame chat. So when Ortiz finally figured out what he wanted to tweet, he posted photos he took with Jarrín. At an All-Star game with Los Angeles Times sports columnist Dylan Hernandez. With Ortiz's now 18-year-old daughter when she was just a toddler. One from this past July, when Ortiz bought upper deck cheap seats at Dodger Stadium and the 85-year-old Jarrín trekked all the way up there to meet him and his family. I love the man because he made me believe that I belong, Ortiz said, his voice trembling. Jarrín's announcement uncorked a parade of rightful tributes that will only escalate over the next 12 months. He and his fellow Baseball Hall of Fame Dodgers broadcaster Vin Scully, after all, gave the Dodgers the greatest one to punch in sports broadcasting history. Generations of Latinos, myself included, listened to Jarrín on AM radio with their Spanish-speaking parents. He not only told us about the Blue Crew's exploits, he did it with a mellifluous, Neruda-esque Spanish that marked him as our collective fancy uncle who still showed up to all the family parties. But there's another Jarrín achievement, probably his most important one, that I didn't consider until Ortiz and dozens of other Latino reporters across the country, in English and Spanish, posted their well wishes on social media. Jarrín isn't just a beloved long-timer, he's the spiritual godfather of every Latino in media.